Apple wants to give me, you, us, everyone, access to genuine parts, tools, and training so we can have the option to self-serve our own repairs. What? I'm Renee Ritchie. Thanks to Morning Brew for sponsoring. Hit that subscribe button so you never miss a big story. Now, let's talk about this. According to Chief Operating Officer Jeff Williams, who you may remember from product announcements like the Apple Watch, this is all about creating greater access to Apple genuine parts and giving customers even more choice if a repair is needed. But is it really? I'll link the full announcement in the description below the like button, but let's just break it all down first. This is an all new, all you self-repair service, which means if you're happy fixing your own kit, if you prefer it even, like if you know what a pentalobe screw even is, Apple will ship you the parts, the tools, and the how-tos, and you'll be able to complete your own repair. That's right, no more
in a cave with a box of scraps,
which is major because Apple famously, infamously, has kept every manual secret and every part locked down forever until now. So this is like the dawning of a new day, or at least the beginning, the starting of a dawning. Maybe you'll go to the Apple self-service repair online store, review the repair manual to make sure you feel safe and comfortable with the process, and when and if you do, you'll order the parts and tools you need. Apple's legendary logistics should ensure a plentiful supply of everything is available, pretty much always. So they'll just ship it out to you, and when you're done installing the new hotness, you'll send back the old broken to Apple and get a credit on your order. That way, Apple can refurbish or recycle everything and anything they can, while you, me, Mr. Beast, and the rest of us all keep working on hashtag Team C's. Now, this is very much a first step, so there are some important caveats. The self-service repair program is starting off in early 2022, but in the US at first, and with the iPhone 12 and iPhone 13 displays, batteries, and camera modules, which are the most common and frequent repairs according to Apple. It will be expanding though to other countries, other parts, and other products, most immediately the M1 Max, all over the course of the next year and more. But to start, that's 8 models of iPhone, including the Minis, Pros, and Pros Max, or Pro Maxes, and over 200 parts and tools, with more to come. And yes, it is really, truly, seriously meant for the high-order bit techno-mechanic nerds out there. Those of you who can strip and refit an iPhone in the field, in the dark, under stress fire from family or friends, faster than Linus can plug the latest water bottle. So just be realistic about your skill level, and if you're more diner than cook, just take your device to an Apple store or trusted repair center and save yourself a ton of extra effort, stress, and expense. Because this ain't IKEA. 3 screws left at the end isn't okay. And jokes aside, lithium-ion batteries aren't anything to screw with. So if at all in doubt, go to a store or arrange to ship it out, because qualified repairs are also available by mail. Now, this is also part of a multi-pronged approach from Apple, starting with making devices more unbreakable to begin with, from ceramic shield on the iPhone 12 and 13, to crack-resistant crystal on the Apple Watch Series 7, to stainless steel and aluminium everything meant to last way, way longer than plastics. But we don't have vibranium or adamantium or uru on this planet, at least not yet. So self-service repair means when something needs fixing, there are now more better options to get it fixed. Will it make every right to repair and consumer protection advocate elf style smiling is my favorite level happy?
No. No.
Will it address regulation of both vendors and indie repair shops?
No. 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 Hell no!
Will we have to wait and see how all of this plays out over the next year and more?
Oh, yeah.
But it does represent a fairly sizable turn of never mind Apple's ship, but their whole entire carrier group, and that ain't nothing either. It's actually one of the two best things I read today, the other being the best newsletter on the net. Today's sponsor, Morning Brew. It's free, it's daily, and in just 5 minutes, it gives me, you, everyone, all the latest in business, tech, entertainment, you name it, everything you need to start your day off smart. And yeah, completely 100% free, 7 days a week, Monday through Friday. Just click the link in the description and get your daily stonks, your crypto highlights, and stories like Disney Plus's slowing growth and what Apple going all in on 5G really means for investors. It's Morning Brew. It's free. It takes all of 15 seconds to subscribe, and it starts your day off smart. So just hit that button on the screen or click the link in the description, and not only will you get a free newsletter you'll actually want to read, but one you will consistently enjoy. Clicking on that button really helps out the channel, and so does hitting up this playlist for more of the most important stories surrounding Apple. Just hit it up, and I'll see you in the next video.